Hi, welcome to Programming with Mesh. In this session, we get acquainted with the list in a more advanced way. We introduce the FlatList and SectionList, and at the end, we have a practice that can be done with what we have learned so far. In the previous session, we got acquainted with the list and how to display it, and made a list with a scroll view that had the ability to pull to refresh. Using SQL views in large arrays will cause you problems, because every time we display the list in it, the whole list is loaded at once. Also, the props it gives us to display a list are few, therefore we preferably use a flat list to display the list. Well, now I will take the SQL view out of the code to get acquainted with the flat list. I do this with the Ctrl and / keys to turn this part of the code into a comment, so that it doesn't run. We create the FlatList component and make sure it's imported. We use data to insert our array in the FlatList. We consider the items array we showed in the previous session as its value. Now we use the render item to display the array items. This prop acts as a map and returns one by one the array items in function. So we can use the same view in it. Here we consider each object as an item for which a view returns. To avoid confusing this item with the item inside the object, I rename the item in the array. I also change the key to a string, because FlatList only accepts the key as a string. So in fact, this item here will be the same objects inside the array. Of course, FlatList doesn't need to define a key in each item, and it's sufficient if the keys are defined in the array. And here we want to display the name of the item. Of course, the reason it didn't show the names is that it didn't identify the item, and we had to put it in parentheses and braces to complete the function. As you can see, the list was displayed correctly. Now suppose our array had no keys. I remove the keys from the array. The warning it gives us says that every item needs a key. We can do this with the key extractor. Inside it, we define a function that returns the item and index of the array, which we can use its index as a key. Or if there is some value in the array items as a key, use it. I use the index here. And as you can see, it warns us that the key type should be a string. So I convert the index to a string. And we have no more warnings. FlatList shows items in a column by default. Using numcolumns, we can specify the number of columns. For example, I give it a value of 2 here. And as you can see, the items are displayed in two columns. FlatList displays the items vertically by default. You can display the items horizontally using the horizontal prop. By default, it scrolls from left to right. Using inverted prop, we can reverse this direction. Now we add the possibility of pull to refresh to our FlatList. This prop works exactly like the prop we gave to SQL view, so we copy it and use it in the FlatList. To remove the code from the comment, we use the same Ctrl and / keys. All we have to do is modify the object we were adding to the array in the onRefresh function. Now if we refresh the list, item 69 will be added to the bottom of the list. And if we repeat this, item 69 will be added again. But this time we will not receive a warning like the previous session, because its key is defined dynamically and the array index is not a duplicate number. Now we want to know another type of list that has the ability to display a nested array. So I define an array and create a title and another array inside its objects. I expand this array with a few other objects. I also remove FlatList from the code and use the SectionList component instead, which is also imported from the React Native library. To define the key, we can act exactly like a FlatList. We use RenderItem to display items like a FlatList. But this time the item only refers to individual items in the internal arrays. So here, if we just display the item, we are actually displaying the internal array items. Now we use render section header to display the title at the top of each of the internal arrays. The function inside this prop returns sections one by one. I use the same previous view to display the title. And from the sections, I select the title to be displayed at the top of each related array. To make the list look better, I put out the items from the view. And as you can see, using section list, we were able to display a nested array. Now, as a practice, create a list similar to this list that includes a header and two items. And by refreshing the list, a header and two other items should be added to it dynamically, although their number has also increased. And we can do this without limits. You can do this practice with what we have learned in these few sessions. So there we go, we got acquainted with FlatList and SectionList. So in the next video, learn more about text input and keyboard. Now if you enjoyed the video, please don't forget to share, subscribe and like. And I'll see you in the next session.